Do you have steady hands and good hand-eye coordination? A passion to work with people and improve their lives? Do you believe in traditional Eastern medicine? Then you may have the potential to become an acupuncturist. Let's get into the life of what's to come. Here are the stages of development of generally what an Eastern practitioner will go through. They will parallel the symbology of the five element theory. Wood represents birth. Fire, growth. Earth, transformation. Metal, harvest. And water, storage. These elemental representations will make more sense as we go on. Let's begin. Wood. During this stage is the birth of a young acupuncturist to be. You would first start by simply ensuring you have all the required prerequisites. To be qualified for an accredited school of Eastern medicine, the minimum requirements are having at least 90 quarter units and having an associate's degree with at least a 2.25 GPA. A background in Western medicine is not required and may confuse you even more. Additionally, there is no entrance exam required, but we do interview you prior to acceptance to ensure that you are the right candidate for this life-changing career. Fire. In this phase, your growth and foundational knowledge of Eastern medicine will increase at a dramatic pace. The classes consist of integrative medicine, which incorporates Eastern and Western diagnosis, treatment, and technique. Also within your courses, you'll learn of biomedicine, herbal medicinal applications, and not to mention also Tuina acupressure, as well as Tai Chi and Qigong meditation, along with many other courses for a total of 2,130 in-class hours. These lessons to be learned are only the tip of the iceberg, for you will now dedicate the rest of your life to learning this ancient practice that has been passed down for thousands of years. Earth. Next is the transformation phase of your life, which will incorporate all of your Eastern medicine knowledge into 960 hours of physical practice. This will be in the conclusion of your schooling during your clinical internships. You will first start as an observer, subsequently moving on to supervised practice, and finally, independent practice. Upon completion of various exams from your school, your state, and also the country, you will then become a licensed practitioner of Eastern medicine. Metal. Congratulations. Now, let's harvest from all of your hard work and dedication because you're a licensed and competent acupuncturist. The opportunities span as wide as your imagination goes. You may open up your own clinic, or there are a variety of other avenues to go down. For example, you may work for a hospital, which utilizes our techniques to assist in oncology. Also, you may work in the pediatrics division or even the fertility clinic. Additionally, you may enjoy a career working for a cruise line. As well, you may practice cosmetic acupuncture or even a practice dedicated towards weight loss. You may also do clinical research, which will prove our amazing medicine through science. And for some last examples, you can also work with a team across borders or for Olympic and professional athletes. Generally, you control your own hours and rate of pay, and it's up to you to keep your best interests in mind. Water. And lastly, this is your storage stage of development. You may now pass all your knowledge and skills you've accumulated for the next generation of practitioners. You're not obligated to teach, but it is beneficial for all of us to carry on the oldest medicinal practice for thousands of years more to come. This is where you can begin teaching in universities, just as when you started, or you can simply take someone under you within your own practice. You have now learned generally of what an acupuncturist's life may have in store for you. If you have any questions or concerns, please do not hesitate to ask a university near you.